Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Vikingard on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5, that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. It packs a punch with mega performance upgrades and it has faster performance than any other high-end Android device or Android platform. We will be able to easily download and install Vikingard and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Vikingard. So without further ado, let's get to it. Before anything else folks, to start we need to open our favorite browser. We selected the one we prefer. Let's continue, going to the next URL I have highlighted in green. Now, you can discover on the screen of the PC. You don't need to type it, simply because there's the clickable link in the description of this video and as well in the first pinned comment. We ended up here on our own site of Usitility, where we get a precise information on how to download and install Vikingard on personal computer. We search down a tad and then click on the Download Game on PC button. After clicking on the link, we arrive here on the site of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we are going to run to play Vikingard on PC. As you can discover from here we access several pros of preferring using that emulator. So we will start downloading the Vikingard by simply clicking on the button play on BlueStacks that you can visualize here in green color. The step is clicking on this button. Of course, the download action takes no time at all. Voila, this is the download. It's an executable file. The following step is to run the executable file, so we need to click on this file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to make modifications to the laptop or device. We have said yes. I minimize the browser to start to see the installation software better. The installation software is straightforward. It is made up of a couple of options, install, and setup path. I am going to show you what setup path truly does. We merely simply click on it. And so we see that we display here the path where the emulator will be set up. If we choose to vary this directory we are required to click on that, browse, option. So we decide on another folder and set up the emulator specifically where we would like. To keep it simple, just set it by default. I simply click on back. Therefore I click on install. Fantastic. The installation commences and it is going to continue with the download of those MB that are shown on this computer screen. The moment you save it on your computer, it might possibly be a bit more or less MB. The download speed may go at a higher speed or slower, based on your connection and according to the performance of the emulator hosting servers. Right away they are working very fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At this time, the emulator has been started successfully. As you can see now, down here, we have a progress bar which will advance to the right so when it attains the finish, the emulator will be started for the first time. The fact is that the emulator has already been started, there for the first time. Before we keep going, as you can see, it created a couple of icons here on the computer desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks software icon is the only one we're concerned about. At any time when we need to start Vikingard on the laptop or computer, we double-click on that icon and as a result use the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in eco mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Let me do the next phase, which is actually a must, and that is to log on to the Google Play Store. And we'll click on Play Store. As you understand, the Google Play is launched. In this case we are required to sign in. Presently when we're on this page, we must accomplish this following step which is absolutely mandatory. So that we mouse click on, sign in. At present it says, checking info. It might once in a while get stuck in checking info, and this isn't going to advance. In this case, you can attempt to connect to your account after a few hours and it'll quite likely be solved. At present we are going to type our username and password. The email ought to be a Gmail email address and its associated password. As an example, you make use of the same exact email you're using currently in your own YouTube account. So I am going to type in my data and I will revisit immediately after I have completed it. Voila! Data typed. Discover Google welcoming us and offering us the twos. We should accept them all by simply clicking, I agree. Then, it offers us to back up to the Google Cloud. You can also leave it checked, it's going to make a backup of your data files on that device to Google Drive. I won't check it. You can utilize this feature if you desire. We just click on accept. Google Play, formerly Android Market, is launched without need to open it manually and completely on its own. To install the app game, we have got to browse the emulator desktop by double-clicking on the app icon indicated green-colored. At this point that we are on the desktop of that emulator for Android, we see that we now have right here the install app button. We click or double-click on this button. On this page we have the Android game. Let's click on here on the install link that I am just highlighting now in green color. This action will start the software setup. Straight away it will install the game app. It might take a bit of time or perhaps it could also be amazingly quickly. That all varies on our own internet access. It has already ended installing. It's time to go back to the emulator desktop by clicking on the following option that I am highlighting in green, so that you can start Vikingard for the first time. You are already on the emulator desktop, and as a consequence we're going to simply click on that brand new Vikingard icon which was provided. Your game is started for the first time. There we have it. I could press anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I have to comment on the sound level of that emulator. It is here. We have got the icon of higher volume as well as the icon of lower volume. This way we don't count on the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound experience of your emulator. And also to enjoy the experience to the greatest, we will turn on the big screen, for which we have two choices. This one is the very first one. We mouse click on this icon which I'm pointing out in green color. Thus the screen is maximized, enjoying one border at the top, one on the right side and the last one at the bottom. In case that we want to launch the application in full screen, we click on this particular application icon. And we might without a doubt be experiencing and enjoying the game in full screen setting. To quit the full screen functionality, hit the F11 key. And we might just play in normal screen setting. At this point, I am going to clarify you the computer keys mapping which is actually quite helpful. This step we will probably be ready to operate the game app far more effortlessly. The first thing is to click on this application icon. It's now time to complete the recommended configurations. I will put the standard configuration, though if you really want to improve this, you may well do this without having problem. Perhaps you have realized, the emulator is completely in our own language. Once in a while it happens that the emulator is started in the improper language, for example, in Mandarin. And so to set it in the appropriate language we go there to the cogwheel. And thus here throughout many other settings, we simply click on the language drop down. We should go for the language we want. German, Mandarin, and so forth. As soon as the language is decided, we are going to save. The emulator will reboot, and the game, next time we launch it, would as well be in the specified language. Presently, there is another point that we have to take into account, and it is that we will get an email saying that a different equipment has been connected with this Google account. It will definitely check with us if we're the individuals who have connected that device. That's right, we shouldn't get worried, considering that the emulator is behaving like an Android tablet or smartphone. And in order to see which tablet or smartphone is currently being emulated, we arrive here, to the cogwheel and we click on it. Be sure you go here to the model selection. And now we discover that the emulator is emulating a Samsung cellular phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it folks, so much for my video user demo. I hope you liked it, specifically that everyone found it interesting. If that's so, bring it a superb thumb up, subscribe, and I will be happy to answer all your feedback, questions or suggestions, put them in the comment box below. You could also leave comments on my Twitch channel. I perform live streams ever so often, you have it below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Simply click any of those online videos which are usually appearing on the screen and see you in the upcoming training videos. Bye.